Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. You are about to see a story of murder, greed, corruption, violence, adultery, and treachery. All these things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you. Five, six, seven, eight.
All that jazz. took the gun officer and I shot him.
I see. And your wife, Roxy Hart, was in no way involved, is that correct?
That's right, officer.
Well, aren't you the cheerful little murderer?
Murderer? Why, just last week the jury thanked a man for shooting a burglar.
Well, that's just fine. Sign right here, Mr. Hart.
Freely and gladly. Freely and gladly.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart, in a song of love and devotion to her dear husband, Amos.
Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care. He'll string along. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. Sometimes I'm down, sometimes I'm up, but he follows around like some droopy eye. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. He ain't no chic, that's no great physique, and Lord knows he ain't got the smarts. Oh, but look at that soul, I tell you that hole is a whole lot greater than the sum of his parts. And if you knew him like me, I know you'd agree. What if the world slandered my name? Well, he'd be right there, taking the blame. He loves me so, and it all suits me fine. That funny, sunny,
his home and his family, right, officer?
Of course he has.
So I come in from the garage, officer, and I see him coming through the garage with my wife Roxanne. They're sleeping there like an angel. An angel!
That funny honey of mine.
Supposing he violated her or something. You know what I mean, violated?
I know what you mean.
Or something. Just think about how terrible that would have been. It's a good thing I got home in time. I say I'm telling you that.
He loves me so. That funny honey of mine.
Fred Casely.
Fred Casely? How could he be the burglar? My wife knows him. He sold us our furniture.
Lord knows he ain't got the smarts.
He lied to me. She told me he was a burglar.
You mean he was dead when you got home?
She had him covered with a sheet, and she's telling me the old cock and bull story about a burglar, and she said that I ought to say that I did it because I was bound
now
to get off.
Now he shut off his
so
trap.
So she was just too tired.
I can't stand
huh?
That. Stop.
Trip.
Look at
she
it
could
go.
Threaten on me. I'm
with just
on 14
one
hours
more thing,
and
what
a
halfway be. If they string me up, I'll know. I'll know who bought the twine. That scummy, crummy, dummy hobby of mine. You double crosser, you said you'd stick, you disloyal husband. Do you want to know what really happened? I shot him. Put that down in your book, palsy. And you want to know why? He was trying to walk out on me.
It's a pretty cold-blooded murder, Miss Hart. Glad to hang you for that one.
Hang me?
Not so tough now, are you?
Oh, Amos, did you hear what they said? They said hang me. Oh, Hail Mary full of grace.
And now, the six merry murderesses of Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
Pop.
Six.
Squish. Uh-uh. Cicero. Lipschitz. Pop.
Six.
Squish. Uh-uh. Cicero. Lipschitz. Pop.
Six.
Cicero.
Lipschitz.
Pop.
Six.
Uh-uh.
Cicero.
Lipschitz.
He had
Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum.
Oh no, not chew.
Pop!
Well, I came home this one evening and I'm very irritated, looking for a little bit of sympathy. And there's Bernie laying on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. Oh no, not chewing. Popping! So I says to him, I says, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head. He had it coming.
He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have heard it, I bet you would have done the same.
I met Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago, and he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, he'd fix me a drink, I'd have dinner. It was like heaven in 2.5 rooms. Only then I found out single, he told me single my butt. Not only was he married, oh no, he had 6 wives. One of those Mormons, you know. So the next day he went to work, he came home, I mixed him a drink. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic.
Pop! Pop! Six! Swish! Cicero Lipschitz! Pop! Six! Swish! Cicero Lipschitz! Pop! Six! Swish! Cicero Lipschitz!
Pop! Now, I'm standing six. In the kitchen carving up a chicken for dinner, minding my own business, and in stores my husband Wilbur in a jealous rage. You've been seeing the milk, and he says, he was crazy, and he kept on screaming, you've been seeing the milkman! Pop. And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same.
Если бы она не знала, как я с ним сошла себя, они все говорили, что это знаменитый резидон поймал моего мужа, но что я его ударила. Но нет, это неправда. Я не виновата. Я не знала, почему дядя Сэм говорит, что это я все сделала, потому что я ничего не сделала. Я попробовала сказать полиции, что я ничего не сделала, но они меня не понимали.
What did you do it?
Not guilty.
My sister Veronica and I did this double act, and my husband Charlie used to travel around with us. Now, for the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Split, spread eagles, backflips, flip-flops, one right after the other. Well, this one night we were in Cicero, 3 of us, sitting up in a hotel room, boozing, having a few laughs. And we ran out of ice, so I went out to get some. I come back, open the door, and there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17. Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out, I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They're coming. They had it coming. Artistic type of guy, sensitive, a painter, but he was troubled. He'd always go out every night looking for himself, and along the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences, for he had seen himself as alive, while I saw him dead.
Dirty bomb, 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 bomb. The dirty bomb, bomb.
Self to blame. If you- And gentlemen, presenting the Keeper of the Keys, the Countess of the Clink, the Mistress of Murderers Row, Matron Mama Morton.
Ask any of the chickies in my pen. They'll tell you I'm the biggest mother hen. I love them all and all of them love me. Because the system works, the system called reciprocity. Got a little motto, always sees me through. When you're good to mama, mama's good to you. There's a lot of favors I'm prepared to do. You do one for mama, she'll do one for you. They say that life is tit for tat, and that's the way I live. So I deserve a lot of sex for what I've got to give. Don't you know that this hand washes that one too? When you're good to mama, mama's good to you.
The Tribune calls me Crime of the Year, and the news says, not in memory do we recall so fiendish and horrible a double homicide.
Ah, oh, baby, you can't buy that kind of publicity. You took care of Mama, and Mama took care of you. You know I talked to Mr. Billy Flynn. He set your trial date for March 5th. March 7th, you'll be acquitted. And March 8th, do you know what Mama's gonna do for you? She's gonna set you on the vaudeville tour.
I've been on a lot of vaudeville tours. What kind of dough are we talking about?
Well, due to your recent sensational activities, I've been talking to the boys in that William Morris, and they could get you about 2,500?
2,500? The most me and Veronica ever made was 350.
Well, that was before Cicero, Billy Flynn, and Mama.
Oh, Mama, I've always wanted to play at Big Jim Calissimo's. Do you think you could get me that?
Oh, Big Jim's? That's another story. That might just require another phone call.
And how much would this phone call cost?
You know how I feel about you. You're like family. I'll do it for 50 bucks.
You must make a lot of wrong numbers.
My gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for mama, she'll get hot for you. When they pass that basket, folks contribute too. You put in for mama, she'll put out for you. The folks atop the ladder are the ones adores. So boost me up my ladder, kid, and I'll boost you up yours. Let's all stroke together like the prince and crew. When you're stroking mama, mama's stroking you. So what's the one conclusion I can bring this number? When you're good to mama, mama's good to you.
my chair.
Who the hell do you think you are?
Are you kidding
me? Oh my god, get off of me! Roxy! Roxy!
This here is Velma Kelly. Do you know who she is? The? Wait, Velma Kelly, the Velma Kelly? Oh my gosh, I read about you in the papers. Hey, I gotta ask you something.
What?
So, the state district attorney, Mrs. Harrison, said that what I'd done is a hanging case, and she's willing to ask for the maximum penalty. I sure would appreciate some advice.
Oh, some advice? Look, kid, I don't give no advice, and I don't take no advice. You're a perfect stranger to me, and let's keep it that way, right, girls?
Thanks a lot.
Oh, you're welcome.
Roxy, relax. In this town, murder is a form of entertainment. You know, and besides, Cook County ain't hung a woman in, what was it, 47 years? So it's 47 to 1 that they won't hang you.
There's always been a first.
Anyway, tell me, Roxy, what are you gonna tell the jury, huh? What are you gonna use for grounds?
I think I'll just tell them the truth.
Oh, telling a jury the truth? Ain't that real stupid?
Yeah, but what's your grounds?
Oh, my grounds. My grounds are that I didn't do it. Oh, I'm sure I couldn't have, because I blacked out completely. And plus, I've the tenderest heart in the world, don't I, Mama?
You betcha sweet patootie you have, Velma.
Is being drunk grounds?
Just ask your lawyer.
I don't have a lawyer.
You don't have a lawyer? Well, as they say in Southampton, you are straight out of luck, my dear. Come on.
So that's Velma Kelly. Ain't she something, huh? She wears nothing but black narcissist perfume and doesn't even make her own bed. Do you know who does that for her?
Me. You make her bed?
Well, the system doesn't really work like that. So basically, Velma pays me $5 a week to do it. Then I called the Russian over there to do it for me. Hey, Katarinochka, look up a lady with a phone from Mrs. Roxy Hart.
Roxy? Roxy Hart?
Roxy, I'm not guilty! Okay, that's all she really ever says. You can sit down, hon. You can sit down. Anyway, you do know who's defending Velma Kelly, don't you?
No, who?
Well, it's the one and only Mr. Billy Flynn.
Who's Billy Flynn? How do I get him?
Oh my god. Well, first, you pay me $100. Then I make a phone call.
And how much does he get?
I think it was $5,000?
$5,000?
Well, listen, dearie, I'd be happy to make that phone call for you any day.
Oh, $5,000? How the hell am I gonna get $5,000?
Ladies and gentlemen,
a tap dance.
Oh, miss, I knew you'd come. I've been so sinful, and I can make it up to you just as soon as I get out of here. There's this Billy Flynn guy, and he costs $5,000.
Roxy, I'm tired of your fancy footwork. The answer is no.
I know I cheated on you. I know I lied to you. I even stole some money from your pants pockets while you were sleeping.
You did?
But I never stopped loving you. Not my Amos, my sweet, handsome Amos. Oh, I'm embarrassed, my sexy Amos.
But $5,000?
It's my hour of need.
All right, Roxy, I'll get it for you. I'll get it for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the silver-tongued prince of the courtroom,
the one, the only, Mr. Billy Flynn.
Here. Is everybody ready? Hit it!
I don't care about expensive things.
about is love.
That's what he's here for.
I don't care if I'm wearing silk cravats, ruby studs, satin spats. I don't mean a thing. All I care about is
love.
Mister, I'm a millionaire. I don't care for any fine attire Vanderbilt might admire. No, no, not me. All I care about is love. Now you may think I'm talking about romance, but I'm not talking about just romance. There's other kinds of love. Love of your fellow man, love of legal procedure, love of justice, love of lending a helping hand to those in need. And, romance ain't so bad either. It may sound odd, all I care about is love. Ra-da-da, honest to God, all I care about is love. Show me long raven hair flowing down about to there. Let me see her running free. Keep your money, that's enough for me. I don't care for driving Packard cars or smoking long a box cigar. No, no, not me. All I care about the guy in who's picking on you, twisting the wrist that's turning the screw. All I care about is
Mr. Billy Flynn's got a new go. Roxy Hawley's got a press conference at 2 o'clock, which is in 5 minutes, so we better go.
Yeah, let's...
Thank you.
Andy?
Amos. My name is Amos.
Right. Have you got the rest of my $5,000?
All right, well, here's a 300 I borrowed from the guys down at the garage, and 500 on my insurance, and 700 on my building and loan fund.
That's 2,000.
That's all I got so far.
Her father?
Well, I phoned him yesterday, and he said he should probably be able to get us some money later.
You know, that's funny, because I talked to her father, and he told me that his daughter went to hell 10 years ago, and that she could stay there forever before he'd put up a cent towards getting her out.
I'll give you $20 off my week's salary. I'll give you notes with interest, double, triple, until every cent is paid.
That's touching, but I've got a motto. Play square, dead square. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask you was she guilty. I didn't ask you was she innocent. I didn't ask you if she was a drunk or a dope fiend. No foolish questions like that, now did I? No. All I asked was, have you got $5,000? And you said yes. But you haven't got $5,000. So, I figure you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took her case, and I'll keep it because I play square. Now look, in a few minutes... Well, now look. We're gonna have her name on every front page in Chicago as the hottest little jazz slayer since Zelma Kelly. Then, we hold an auction to raise money for her defense. They'll buy everything she ever touched, shoes, dresses, underwear. Plus, we tell them that if by due process of law, she gets hanged.
Hanged?
Hanged. The stuff triples in value. I'll give you everything we make. I'll give you 20% of everything we make over $5,000. And that's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. Either I get the entire 5,000, or you'll rot in jail before I bring you to trial.
Oh, Mr. Flynn, I'm not very good at this sort of thing, but couldn't we make some arrangement between us?
Look, you mean one thing to me, and that's $5,000. Now, in a few minutes, there'll be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters, and that sob sister from the Evening Star, Mary Sunshine's coming.
Mary Sunshine is gonna interview me? Holy crap!
And pipe down on the swearing. From here on in, you say nothing more than oh dear. Now look, the first thing we have to go after from the press is sympathy. So they're not all pushovers like that Mary Sunshine. Chicago's a tough town. It's gotten so tough that they shoot the girls right out from under you, but there's one thing they can never resist, and that is a reform sinner. So I've decided to rewrite your life story from convent to jail. Get this. Beautiful southern home, every luxury and refinement. Parents, dead. Educated at the Sacred Heart. Fortune swept away. A runaway marriage. A young girl, bewildered by what's happened. So full of life, lonely. She got caught up in the mad whirl of a great city. Jazz, cabarets, liquor, sit down. You were a moth drawn to a flame. But now the mad world has ceased. And you were a butterfly crushed on the wheel. You've sinned. And you're sorry.
God, that's beautiful.
And I cut out God, too. Stay where you're better acquainted. Now, look. When they ask you why you killed him, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel and that he threatened to kill you. You can still see him coming towards you with that awful look in his eyes. And get this. You both reached for the gun. That's your grounds, self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporters are here.
Let him in. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sunshine, you know my client, Miss Roxy Hart.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I'm so flattered y'all came to see little old me. I bet you want to know why I shot him.
Sit down, dummy.
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rag.
Notice how mouth never moves. Almost.
Mississippi. Very wealthy. 6 feet under, but she was granted one more start. The Convent of the Sacred Heart. 1920. Don't remember. Convinced me to elope one day.
It's too terrible, you poor, poor dear.
Who's Fred Casely?
My ex-boyfriend.
Why did you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Still, I said, Fred, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong. He came toward me
with a pistol
from my bureau. Like a tiger, he had strength and she had none. And yet we both reached for the gun. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, we both, oh yes, we both, oh yes, we both reached for the gun, the gun, the gun, the gun. Oh yes, we both reached for the gun, for the gun. Understandable, understandable. Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
How you feeling?
Very frightened.
Are you
you kidding?
All I'm saying is, don't make you do dump the track. I give my life to bring him back.
And
stay away from what? Jazz and liquor.
And
the men who
what?
Play for fun.
And what?
That's the thought that
yeah.
came upon me
when
we both reached for the gun.
Understandable, understandable.
Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible, not a bit reprehensible, it's so defensible.
Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, they go, oh yes, they go, oh yes, they go, reach for the
I can't hear you. A little louder. Come on! Now you got it!
Short, I started getting around, and then I started screwing around, which is getting around without dinner, you know? I skipped the whole vaudeville idea because, you know, the opportunity just passed you by, but now I got a whole world full of yes! Oh, yes! The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy, the lady raking in the chips is gonna be Roxy. I'm gonna be a celebrity, that means somebody everyone knows. They're gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my
my teeth, my legs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxy. Who says that murder's not an art? And who, in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang? Roxy Hart. I'm gonna have a swell act too. I'm gonna get me a boy to work with, someone who can lift me up and show me off. Oh, hell, I'll get two boys. It'll frame me better. Wait, Roxy, think big. Oh, think bigger. I think I'm gonna get me a whole bunch of boys. Oh, yeah. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be
Roxy.
The lady raking in the chips is gonna be
Roxy. She's gonna be a celebrity.
That means somebody everyone knows.
They're gonna recognize her eyes, her hair, her teeth.
My legs, my nose.
Baby, I've got some bad news.
What do you mean?
I mean the tour, It's canceled.
Canceled?
I mean, you know your name hasn't been popping in the Nays newspaper lately, and I've been getting calls from the boys at William Morris. Do you know what I've been hearing? She's washed up. She's a bum. We've lost interest. Do you know how much it hurts Mama to hear that kind of stuff about somebody she's so deeply canceled?
Oh, sure.
I mean, all you read about today is that Hawkett. I mean, look at her.
You know what, Mama? That actually gives me an idea. Say I talk this heart kid into doing that sister act with me.
Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. My sister and I were headed straight for the top. My sister and I earned a sow a week at least, oh sure. But my sister is now, unfortunately, deceased. Oh, I know it's sad, of course, but a fact is still a fact. And now all that remains is the remains of a perfect double act. And Roxy, do you know, by the looks of it, you're the exact same size as my sister. You would fit into her wardrobe perfectly. Look, why don't I just show you some of the act, huh? Watch this. Now, you have to imagine it with two people. It's swell with two people. First I, bada 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 drums. Then she, wah 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 wah, saxophone. Then we, bada bada bada, wada wada, together. But I can't do it alone. Then she. Then I. Then we. But I can't do it alone. She'd say, what's your sister like? I'd say, men, but I'm cheap. She'd say, you're the cat's meow. Then we'd wow the crowd again when she'd go. I'd go. Okay, fellas, keep your socks up. You ain't seen nothing yet. Yeah. Uh-huh. Woo! But I simply cannot do it alone. Well, what do you think so far? Come on, look, don't be shy, you can say.
Let me tell you, it's very...
Okay. Well, the first part could always be rewritten. Yeah, sure. But the second part was really nifty, okay? Watch this. Then she'd... Then I... Then we'd... Chicago in. I'd say, ew. You got that one? She'd say, turn your motor off. Ring, 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 ring. I can hear them cheering still. When she'd go, I'd go. Around to cheer the best attraction in town. They nearly tore the balcony down. And we'd say, okay, fellas, okay, we're going home. But here's a few more parting shots. And this we did in perfect unison.
shows in jails nowadays. I remember a time where you were in jail.
Okay, Roxy, I'll level with you.
Listen, what did Mama just tell you? It's me they want now, huh? I'm a star, a big star. Single.
All right, I get it.
Nothing personal, you understand.
Nothing personal. Nothing's ever personal.
Like a deserted bride on her wedding night, all alone and shaking with fright, with her brand new hobby nowhere in sight. I simply cannot do it. She notices something rather odd, all right? Very odd, okay? Extremely odd, she goes to change. And when she returns, oh, whew, she gently awakens Harry.
Oh, Harry!
Are you gonna believe what you see or what I tell you?
What I see. Oh, good night, Harry.
Your questions.
Ugh, go to hell! Hold on a second. Do you know who my father is? Mr. Jones, all of Hawaii. So you can go to hell, all of you!
Step right in, really, step right in. She'll Mr. be happy
Flynn,
to answer your questions,
Mr.
and
Mr.
afterwards
Flynn.
I'll give you an interview myself.
Mr. Flynn!
Yeah, hi, Trixie.
Trixie?
Roxy, I said Roxy. What a hellion, huh? Her father owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
How do I care about pineapples if you get my trial date?
Take it easy, kid, I'll get to it.
Mr. Flynn, look, there's a couple things I'd like to discuss about my trial, too.
Hi, Velma. First things first. Miss Sunshine, can I call you Mary? She's from Old Pineapple Money. It's a gripping story, really.
Pineapples. I got a feeling you're in trouble, Roxy.
Socialite. You'll lose again, Velma.
There's only one person who can help you now, Roxy.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Miss Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
I am my own best friend.
Somebody take that girl to the infirmary.
Do you see this? All that jazz.
Trial at the earliest possible moment. You can quote me on that.
Hey, everybody! I'm the father! I'm the father!
Me and my baby and me, a dream of a duo. Now, don't you agree? Why keep it mum when there's nothing to hide? And what I feel I must reveal is more than I can keep inside. Let me assure you, it won't go away. I can assure you, it grows every day. I was a one once, but now I'm a we. Cause I got my baby, my dear little baby. Look at my baby and me.
I think it's sweet, you know. First time we got one of the girls into the family thing.
got it. And it's brilliant. I'm gonna get Amos to divorce her. That way all the sympathy will go to her and not him. She'll be the poor little deserted mother-to-be, and that crumb will be running out
on her. That's my kid! That's my kid!
Look at my baby and me, facing the world optimistically. Nothing can stop us, so nobody try. This baby's rough and full of suffering, incidentally, so am I.
One day I went to school, and when I come home, they'd moved. If someone stood up in a crowd and raised his voice up way out loud and waved his arm and shook his leg, you'd notice him. If someone in the movie show yelled fire in the second row, this whole place is a powder keg. You'd notice him. And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Unless, of course, that person it should be invisible. Inconsequential me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there.
Andy?
Amos. My name is Amos.
Right, it was the kid's name I was thinking about.
What kid?
Roxy's kid. You know when she's due, right? Early fall? September? Can you count? Means you couldn't possibly be the father. But hey, I want you to pass out those cigars anyway. I don't want you to care when people laugh.
Laugh? Why would people laugh?
Because they can count. Now, Roxy signed a statement saying you and her hadn't copulated within 4 months to the incident.
That's right, we hadn't done no copulating for 4 months, early fall. Now wait a minute.
Hey, but I want you to forget about all that. My client needs your support.
But that don't figure out right. I couldn't possibly be the father.
Divorce her? My God, man! You wouldn't divorce her over a small thing like that, now would you?
You're damn right that's what I'll do! I'll divorce her! She probably wouldn't even notice.
Oh. Thought you'd gone.
I'm still here. I think. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat who fed you fish and scratched your ears.
you'd notice him. Suppose you was a woman wed, sleeping in a double bed, besides one man for 7 years. You'd notice him. A human being's made of more than air. With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless that human being next to you is unimpressive, unimportant, you know who. Shut up in my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, shut up in my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. Never even know I'm there.
Hope I didn't take up too much of your time.
Ladies, Diesel, get Roxy for me, will you?
Mr. Flynn, boy, am I glad to see you. Look, come here. March 5th is only a few weeks away, and I've been making plans for the trial. I'm thinking, I got this great pair of silver shoes with rhinestone buckles back in my cell.
Velma, your trial date's been pushed back.
What do you mean?
Only a few weeks. I had to. I'm sorry.
And who got my date as if I didn't know? Miss Roxy Hart?
Look, I'm under a lot of pressure with the baby and all.
Yeah, Jeff, listen, Flynn, tell me about it. I figure if I'm a sensation in court, I can really get things moving again. Couldn't I just show you what I thought I might do when I get on the witness stand?
Go ahead.
Good. Hit it! Well, when I got on the stand, I thought I'd take a peek at the jury. Then I crossed my legs like this, you know.
When Velma takes the stand.
Then when Harrison cross-examines me, I thought I'd give him this. And if he yells at me, I thought I'd tremble like this. Ooh, no, please, don't! Then I thought I'd let it all be too much for me, like real dramatic. Oh, oh! Then I thought I'd get thirsty, and I'd say, please, someone, could I have a glass of water? And that's when I have to ask you for yours. I really like that part, don't you? But oh wait, then I get up and I try to walk, but I'm too weak. So I slump and I slump and I slump and I slump until finally I faint.
Thank you.
criticism.
Yeah, sure.
It stinks.
I'll see you, Velma.
Okay. All right. I get it. I'm not stupid. I'm not wanted. I'll go. But not quietly. May I have my exit music, please? Please. Thank you.
There you are. I've been waiting for you for 10 minutes. Don't do that again. Now look, I got Amos to file for divorce.
So now what?
So now we get him on the stand and we get him to admit that he made a terrible mistake and that he still loves you. And of course you still love him. And the jury will be falling all over themselves to play Cupid and get you back together again. Smart, huh?
Smart, huh?
And another thing?
And another thing?
When Amos is on the stand, I want you to be knitting a baby garment.
I don't know how to knit.
Then learn.
Listen, I am sick of everyone treating me like I'm some dumb common criminal.
You are some dumb common
criminal.
Well,
that's better than being a greasy lawyer who's out for all he can stand.
Fine. Maybe you'd like to appear in court without me then.
Well, maybe I could. Have you read the morning papers, palsy? They love me.
You're a phony celebrity, kid. In a couple of weeks, nobody will even know you exist. And that's Chicago.
You are fired.
I quit.
We'll see about that.
Oh, no, Roxy, no, no, no.
And I want my $5,000 back, too.
No. Mama, no, no, niet, niet, no.
Sorry,
no.
Sorry.
No, 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 no.
Erin, she still says no. Why can't she still says no?
Jesus Christ, don't she know she'll be convicted?
Niet, niet. Dat is een хороше и добре. У меня ничего не плохо не стало, потому что он знает, что я не виновата.
She says that she's just an innocent, and Uncle Sam would not put her in jail. I'm starting to think she's telling the truth, Erin.
Oh, what the hell has innocence got to do with it? Look, Mrs. Moore, this is a court-appointed thing. I don't get anything from this. Nothing.
Well, what do you want from me? I've done my best.
Not guilty.
Foreigners.
Почему Uncle Sam меня не любит? Ну почему?
She's saying, well, Uncle Sam, why doesn't he like her?
I don't give a damn what she says unless it's guilty. Guilty!
Not guilty!
You ready for you?
Well, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you an entertainment. The one, the only Katalin Hunyak in the famous Russian rope trip.
Not guilty. 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 Not guilty.
After 47 years, a Cook County precedent has been shattered. Katalin Hunyak was hanged tonight for the brutal axe murder of her husband. The Russian's final words were, not guilty.
Billy, I'm so sorry. I'll do anything you say.
So we're clear about what you're doing on the stand?
Oh, yes, sir. I've been up all night rehearsing.
All right, let's get to my summation. I'm going to start with America and justice, blah, blah, blah. Then I'll get to your repentance. Then I'll say, if sorrow could avail, Fred Casely would be here now. For she would give her life and gladly to bring the dead man back, you nod.
That's it?
It's all for now. Then I'll say, but we can't do that, gentlemen. You may take her life, but it won't bring Casely back. It's always news to them. Then, I'll go into my final statement, winding up. We can't give her happiness, but we can give her another chance. And that's all for you.
Like hell it is. It's me they want to see, not you.
It's my speech that brings them in. And it's my speech that'll save your neck.
You damn old crook!
Shut up, you dirty little...
His honor's here.
Thank you. Just a moment. You ready?
Billy, I'm scared.
You got nothing to worry about, kid. It's all a circus. A three-ring circus. These trials. The whole world. All show business. But kid, you're working with the star. The biggest. Give on the old razzle-dazzle. Razzle-dazzle 'em. Give them an act with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give them the old hocus-pocus, beat and feather them. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges all are rusting? What if, in fact, you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle 'em, and they'll never catch wise. Give them the old razzle-dazzle, razzle-dazzle. Give them an act that's so splendiferous, row after row will grow vociferous. Give them the old flim-flam-flummix, fool and fracture them. How can they hear the truth above the roar? Throw on my fake and off an eagle. They'll never know you're just a bagel. Razzle dazzle them, and they'll beg you for more. Stun and stagger 'em. When you're in trouble, go into your dance. Though you are stiffer than a girder, they'll let you get away with murder. Razzle dazzle, and you've got a romance. Give 'em. Dazzle, razzle, dazzle 'em. Give 'em an act that's unassailable. They'll wait a year till you're available. Give 'em the old double whammy, daze and dizzy 'em. Show 'em the first-rate sorcerer you are. You keep them way off balance. How can they spot you got no talents? Razzle dazzle 'em. Razzle dazzle 'em, and they'll make you a star. We present justice.
The state of Illinois versus Roxy Hart for the murder of Fred Casely. Thank you.
The state calls
Mr. Amos Hart.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Truth, truth, truth. Sup, you got?
I certainly do.
Questioned by Sergeant Fogarty, what happened next? Answered by Roxy Hart, I shot him because he was walking out on me. The louse. Do you recognize this signature?
Yes, ma'am, I do. It's a signature of the woman who used to be my wife.
Exactly! Take the witness.
Hello, Amos?
Amos, yes, Mr. Flynn. My name is Amos.
Amos, you were at present obtaining a divorce from the defendant. Any reason?
Well, I'll say the newspaper said she was expecting a little stranger.
It's hardly grounds for divorce, is it?
A little too much of a stranger.
By that you mean you doubted the paternity of the child.
Well, sure.
Did you even bother to ask Mrs. Hart if you were the father?
No, but you told
just
me
that— jumped to a conclusion, huh? I hardly call that playing square. If Roxy Hart swore that you were the father of her child, which she does—
She does?
I do!
She does. Step down, Pops. The defense calls Roxy Hart.
Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Truth, truth, truth. Selfie God?
I do.
What is your name?
Roxy.
Roxy. I have here a statement in which you admit having had an illicit relationship with the deceased Fred Casely. Is this statement true or false?
I'm afraid it's true.
You're an honest girl, Roxy. When did you first meet Fred Casely?
When he sold Amos and me our furniture. Also, he was a regular patron at the nightclub where I was a member of the chorus.
Justice! Justice! Justice!
And your personal relationship with him, when did that begin?
When he decided to drive me home one night.
Hey, sweetheart.
Hello, Mr. Casely.
Fine night for ducks, ain't it? Why don't I give you a drive home, you know, with the rain in and all?
Oh, he seemed like such a nice gentleman.
Yet you were married, Mrs. Hart.
Oh, I'm afraid so. But I don't think I would have done it if me and Amos hadn't quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled about what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to be working at that cheap Southside nightclub.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't want you working those long hours at the garage either.
Sure, sure.
Oh, Amos, I want a real child.
That chance.
So you drifted into this illicit relationship because you were unhappy at home.
Most unhappy.
I love
ya. I love ya.
But you do respect the sacredness of the marriage vow.
Oh, yes, sir.
Then why didn't you stop this affair with Casely?
Well, because Mr. Casely, he'd plead and he'd say,
I can't live without you. I can't live without you. I can't live without you. I can't live without you.
I love you.
Roxy Hart, the state has accused you of the murder of Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty. Not guilty. Oh, I killed him, yes, but I'm not a criminal.
Oh, there, 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 there. Roxy, can you recall the night of February 14th?
Yes, sir.
Tell the jury in your own way.
All right, well, it was about 2 a.m., and I went to get some groceries at an all-night store to get some baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos.
Oh, Amos just loved my cupcakes.
And then I went home and I decided to go to bed, and the doorbell rang.
Ding dong!
Now, I thought it was my friend Gloria, so I slipped on my kimono and I went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casely!
What did he say?
That note you wrote me, telling me it was over? Why'd you write it?
Because I've seen my errors, my ways, and...
And?
And?
And when you asked him to, did he go away?
I object. The council is leading the witness.
Sustained.
I'll rephrase the question. What did you say?
I said, go away!
Eat it, buddy!
No good will come of this, and besides, I love my husband.
So you told him that you loved your husband, and what did he say to that?
It don't matter. You're mine! You're mine! You're mine!
No, Roxy, you must. The jury has a right to know.
Okay. In a passion, he ripped off my kimono and threw me to the floor. Mr. Hart's revolver was laying between us, and we both went to get it, but I knocked it from his hand. And then he whirled me aside.
And then what happened?
And then Mr. Hart's revolver was right between us. We both reached for the gun, but I got it first.
I mean to kill you.
Did you think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
So it was his life or yours?
And not just mine. So I closed my eyes and I shot.
But sweetheart.
In defense of your life.
To save my husband's unborn child.
Yeah, I bet it has.
Seated next to her attorney, Mr. Billy Flynn, she weeps, but she fishes through her bag and she can't find a handkerchief.
A handkerchief?
Mama, can you stretch a trap?
Her attorney, Mr. Flynn, hands her one.
That's my bit. She's stealing my bit, Mama.
Oh, the poor child has no relief. She looks around, bewildered, seeming to want something. Oh, it's a glass of water. The baby
That's
hands
my
her
bit,
one.
Too.
Really?
Mrs. Hart, her usual grace herself, thanks the bailiff, and he smiles at her. She just looks simply radiant in her stylish red dress and elegant silver shoes.
With rhinestone buckles?
With rhinestone buckles.
Oh, my God!
Can you take it easy, all right? Take it easy.
Those were my shoes, and she stole them!
Well, maybe you couldn't have been an imbecile and left them out in the open.
First, she steals my publicity, then she steals my lawyer, then my trial date, and now my shoes?
Well, listen, she's a lowbrow. The whole world's gone lowbrow. So what are you gonna do about it, huh?
Nothing, I guess.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final day of the trial of Roxy Hart has come. A hush has fallen over the courtroom as Billy Flynn prepares his summation to the jury. The next voice you will hear will be that of Mr. Flynn, champion of the town trial.
Ladies and gentlemen, you and I have never killed. We can't know the agony, the hell, that Roxy Hart has been through. This drunken beast, Fred Casely, forced his way into her home, forced liquor upon her, physically abused her, and threatened to kill her. In that moment, motherly instinct and a deep concern for her neighbor stirred within her. She shot him. We don't deny that. But she has prayed to God for forgiveness for what she's done. Yes, you may take her life, but it won't bring Casely back. We can't give her happiness, but we can give her another chance. The defense rests.
Let's try this.
Order in the court!
Juror one, will you please approach the bench? Honestly, has the jury reached a verdict?
Oh, yeah, we have, Your Honor.
Thank you. May the defendant please rise. Thank you. And what is the jury's verdict?
You won't believe what's going on out there. There was this divorce action, and then this babe shot her husband, hurt his mother, and the defense attorney. There's blood everywhere, but what a gripping story. And Velma Kelly was acquitted today.
guilty, that's what happened.
Well, why didn't the press want my picture?
Look, I saved your life.
Take your hanky back. You get $5,000. What do I get?
You're a free woman, Roxy Hart. God save Illinois. My exit music, please.
Roxy.
I want
you to come home with me. You said you still wanted me, and I still love you, and the baby, our baby.
Baby? Jesus, who do you take me for? There ain't no baby.
There ain't no baby?
That's right.
Well, Roxy, I still love you.
They didn't even want my picture. I just don't understand. They didn't even want my picture.
My exit music, please. Okay.
Finest home of family entertainment is proud to announce a first. For the first time anywhere, a show like this has been performed. You've read about them in the papers, and here they are for you now. Chicago's own killer dealers, those scintillating sinners, Roxy Hart and Velma Kelly! Okay, you lovers of jazz, let's pick up the pace. Let's shake the blues away and all make the parties longer and the skirts shorter and shorter. Let's make the music harder and all go to hell in a fast car and keep it hot.
What a wonderful country this is!
And we just like to thank you.
Thank you.